Joint Services, SIMS. Okay, is this, am I audible? The first part of my presentation would be something that you would teach me, and at the end of that part you'll get handouts of what we have gone through. And after that, during the second part, that is SIMS, and I'll tell you why, would be a kind of boring sort of session. You will just go through a few slides, but you will get handouts and you will know why. We won't talk a lot about that. So my topic for today is number one, childhood immunization. Edward Jenner was the first person in about 200 years, 250 years back, who did an experiment of vaccinating a child. And then he, what he said was vaccination was something he discovered that is a useful way of preventing disease. And vaccination, by the way, is derived from Latin word vacca. Vacca means cow. At that time, cowpox was very common. Smallpox was very common. The infection in cows could prevent infection in humans, and that was how he invented this a new technique. Later on, Louis Pasteur, as his name is, was a person who made new vaccines for rabies, and later on this technique was established and new vaccines were developed. Very briefly, you all know about immunity. And there are two types of immunity. One is innate immunity, that is in the species, in the organisms, and this is the first line of defense. We can't, you know, alter that. Second is adaptive immunity, that is where we hit in immunization. Immunization again is of two types. One is passive immunization. You take the immunoglobulins and give it to a person. He becomes immune for as long as he has those immunoglobulins. And the second is active, in which you make a person immune by producing memory cells in that person, and he can produce immunoglobulins against a certain infection whenever there is a challenge. Now, what is a good vaccine? This is very briefly, for your interest, is a vaccine that is immunogenic, that is capable of inducing adequate immunity. There are certain vaccines that are not very immunogenic. Then a vaccine that mimics natural infection, that is whatever it does is like the natural infection, and it provides long-lasting protection. It has long gaps between boosters. So if you've given a vaccine, the next vaccine that you need to give to maintain the level of immunity should be very long. It should not be reactogenic, that is, should have minimum side effects and is stable. Now, what are the different type of vaccines? Can you help me? Can anybody tell me the type of vaccines that you know of?
Live vaccines.
Live vaccines, okay. Live attenuated vaccines ek hi ho gayi, theek hai, because we can't give live organisms which are invasive. If we give those organisms, that those would produce disease, so they have to be attenuated. So ek ho gayi live vaccines.
Killed
vaccines, okay.
Toxoids
are those vaccines in which toxins are made less, or their immunogenicity is maintained, whereas their disease producing ability is taken care of, and that helps. Or
polysaccharide
vaccine, okay. What else? genetically engineered vaccines. Subunit vaccines. Conjugate, okay. Or we have given names, or so in ke aage in ke examples. So live attenuated, ki koi example bata dijiye. Polio, BCG, measles, mumps, rubella, MMR. आजकल और आ गई है चिकन पॉक्स. ठीक है, ओके. नाउ लेट मी ऑल्सो टेल यू एट दिस मोमेंट दैट वी आर गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट रूटीन वैक्सीनेशन ओनली इन दिस, बिकॉज वैक्सीनेशन इज़ अ वेरी वास्ट टॉपिक. वी आर नॉट गोइंग टू टच अबाउट दोज वैक्सीन दैट आर नॉट रूटीनली गिवन, लाइक रेबीज इज़ नॉट रूटीनली एडमिनिस्टर्ड, येलो फीवर वैक्सीन एंड अदर वैक्सीन विच आर नॉट, एंड दोज वैक्सीन दैट आर स्टिल एक्सपेरिमेंटल और स्टिल नॉट लाइसेंस इन मोस्ट ऑफ द वर्ल्ड, लाइक रोटा वायरस वैक्सीन का आजकल बड़ा जिक्र है. वी आर नॉट गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट, वी आर गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट रूटीन वैक्सीनेशन ओनली. सो ये हो गया. कोई मुझे बताएंगे जेनेटिकली इंजीनियर्ड वैक्सीन का कोई नाम? हेपेटाइटिस बी वैक्सीन, ओके. वट अबाउट टॉक्सॉइड? पर्टसिस हो गया, डिफ्थीरिया हो गया, टेटनस हो गया. पर्टसिस नहीं है, पर्टसिस का कुछ और है. पर्टसिस इज समथिंग एल्स. वो किस किस्म की वैक्सीन है? पर्टसिस किस किस्म की वैक्सीन है? सो लेट अस सी व्हाट आर द डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ वैक्सीन दैट वी हैव. रिमेंबर, हम एक चीज़ भूल गए इसमें, हमें वायरल को अलहदा करना है, बैक्टीरियल को अलहदा कर दें. देर वैक्सीन दोज आर अगेंस्ट वायरसेस एंड दीज मे बी attenuated like polio, measles, MMR, varicella. There is a polio vaccine which was previously available in Pakistan but is not now available, which was injectable and that was not live attenuated. Abhi bhi duniya ke kai mulkon mein, like in Israel, like in certain European countries, that vaccine is given routinely. Killed and inactivated hepatitis A and that injectable polio virus and genetically engineered hepatitis. These are the vaccines that are viral vaccines, vaccines against viral diseases. Then bacterial vaccines are live attenuated is BCG. Whole cell vaccine, ye wali ek bhul gaye. This is pertussis whole cell vaccine. The normal pertussis vaccine, which is part of which vaccine? DPT is a whole cell vaccine. Then toxoids are diphtheria and tetanus. The subunit, there is a newer pertussis vaccine which is subunit vaccine that does not contain the whole organism, and that is given especially in those children, we'll come to that in a moment, who develop reaction to whole cell vaccine. And then polysaccharide vaccines, these are hip typhoid ki ek type hai, meningococcal vaccine. And of course this is not a separate entity, this is actually among these, because now we like to give less and less pricks to a child, so these vaccines are combined and they are given as single shots. In the decade of 70s and late 60s, the World Health Authorities, they wanted to eradicate smallpox from the face of this earth, and they could do so by use of one vaccine, and that was smallpox vaccine. That is probably the biggest single victory of mankind against any disease. And the success of this program led to development of another program which was called expanded program of immunization, which was targeted against 6 vaccine preventable diseases: diphtheria, pertussis, tetanus, tuberculosis, measles and mumps, tuberculosis and polio. So these are the six diseases that were targeted. And the program was named Extended because it was at that time perceived that with passage of time, we would have newer vaccines against other diseases and the program would keep on expanding, which in fact it is. So would you kindly help me and tell me what are the vaccines and what is the schedule that is given as part of EPI program of Pakistan? हमारे यहाँ पे जो प्रोग्राम है उसमें क्या शेड्यूल है, कैसे वैक्सीन दी जाती है? सबसे पहले BCG. When? At birth. Plus polio. फिर ओके DPT, पोलियो एंड समथिंग एल्स, हेपेटाइटिस बी. Okay, then remember these are not booster doses, ये primary doses हैं, ठीक है. फिर उसके बाद same at one month interval and then same at one month interval and lastly hemophilus is not part of EPI, measles at 9 months. So this program is what we call as expanded program of immunization. Is this all right? Is there any problem with this program?
Measles is not
indicated. मुझे एक्चुअली सुनाई नहीं दे रहा. जी हाँ जी, सब तरफ नहीं हो रहा. देर आर थ्री काइंड ऑफ रीजन्स इन द वर्ल्ड बेस्ड ऑन एपिडेमियोलॉजी ऑफ हेपेटाइटिस बी. देर हाई रिस्क, इंटरमीडिएट रिस्क एंड लो रिस्क. एंडेमिसिटी के तीन लेवल हैं. हेपेटाइटिस बी इज एंडेमिक ऑल ओवर. देर लोअर एंडेमिसिटी एरियाज, इंटरमीडिएट एंड हाई एंडेमिसिटी एरियाज. आर्स इज हाईली एंडेमिक एरिया. This vaccine is routinely recommended in those areas where there is high prevalence. The reason is that because there the chances of perinatal transmission is high and the chances of becoming a chronic carrier if the disease is transmitted at the time of birth is more than 90%. So more than 90% of children, if they are not taken care of, would become carrier of hepatitis B if they are born to mothers having. The idea is not, this is not targeted to the mother, this is targeted to disruption of transmission of disease in the community. सो अगर ओवरऑल प्रेवलेंस गिरेगी तो मदर्स भी कम होंगी और वो होगी. वो एक सेपरेट क्वेश्चन है, वो हम बाद में वो कर लेंगे. ओके, द प्रॉब्लम ऑफ दिस प्रोग्राम इज दैट बिफोर 1992 द प्रोग्राम ऑफ EPI वाज सपोर्टेड बाय USAID एंड द प्रोग्राम लास्टेड टिल 5 years ऑफ एज, विच इंक्लूडेड बूस्टर्स एट 1.5 years एंड लेटर ऑन बूस्टर एट 5 years. And that is how we give full immunity for a longer period of time. In 1992, USAID उन्होंने हाथ छोड़ दिए, कहा जी बस ये आपके बच्चे हैं, आप वो करें. सो हमने कहा जी हमारे बच्चे हैं तो भाड़ में जाएं. सो वी स्टॉप गिविंग वैक्सीन्स टू एंड वी मेड अ पॉलिसी दैट द वैक्सीन्स वुड बी गिवन टू चिल्ड्रन अप टू 1 year ऑफ एज ओनली. इवन इन इंडिया, our neighboring country, the EPI program is up to 5 years of age. So those people who are related with the specialty of pediatrics, they would recommend other schedules. There is wide variation in these schedules. You pick up any book, you search any literature, you would find some difference between the schedules. I'll just go through one of those schedules, which is a schedule that is recommended by Indian Academy of Pediatrics, and that I have quoted because they have a similar kind of environmental conditions that we have. Therefore, this might be relevant in our setup. In this, at birth, in addition to hepatitis, in addition to BCG and OPV, hepatitis B first dose is, should be given right at time of birth, and later on at 2 months or 6 weeks. हेपेटाइटिस 2 इज़ गिवन एंड सॉरी ये यहाँ पे नहीं है ये वो गलती से वो डिलीट नहीं हुआ एंड एट 6 months हेपेटाइटिस 3 इज़ गिवन 9 months पे मीजल्स एंड रिमेंबर दिस इज 9 months कम्प्लीटेड नॉट अर्ली 9 months इज 270 डेज प्लस लेट 9 months एंड आफ्टर दैट दिस इज ऑप्शनल Chickenpox, it is an expensive vaccine. Only one shot is required for lifelong immunity. MMR, this is not optional. It should be given because the injection of measles given at 9 months or 10 months does not give full immunity. This is still a period in which maternal immunoglobulins may be there and they may interfere with development of with this immunity in the child. So MMR should be given at 15 months and 18 months DPT booster should be given. At 2 years typhoid and then later on every 2 to 3 years typhoid should be repeated. At 5 years what we normally रीड इन लिटरेचर इज डी टी कहते हैं कि जी अब बच्चे का पर्टसिस का कम हो गया चांस और डी टी दें बट इंडियन अकेडमी ऑफ पीडियाट्रिक्स स्टिल सेज दैट डी पी टी शुड बी गिवन बिकॉज वी हैव सीन दैट पर्टसिस इज सीन इवन इन चिल्ड्रन एंड एट 10 years द एडल्ट टेटनस एंड डिफ्थीरिया नो साइड इफेक्ट्स आर सीन एट एनी एज एट एनी एज सो वो बच्चों में भी उतना छोटों में भी उतना ही होगा एक अच्छा वील गो थ्रू दीज क्वेश्चन वाई डोंट यू राइट डाउन दोज क्वेश्चन वील गो थ्रू दीज एट दैट एक और वैक्सीन है इसमें हिब हिब इज हिमोफिलस इन्फ्लुएंस दिस अगेन इसका कलर मैंने डिफरेंट किया दिस अगेन इज अ वैक्सीन दैट इज in our part of the world still optional. This is against Haemophilus influenza type B, which is one of the causative organisms of pneumonia and meningitis. What the pediatricians are trying is that this vaccine should be included routinely in the EPI program. In Western countries, it is part of routine immunization. Hepatitis A is again a kind of optional vaccine because hepatitis A does not have mortality, a significant mortality, although there is significant morbidity. And this is a relatively expensive vaccine once again. Okay, immunization should also be of the mothers. Because one of the diseases in this program is tetanus, which is significantly mortal if it occurs in newborns, and their maternal immunity is important. So all mothers should receive 5 doses of tetanus toxoid. First 2 in the first pregnancy or the pregnancy in which the mother has seeken advice or gone to the vaccination center. Third, 6 months after the second dose or if the next pregnancy comes earlier. Fourth and fifth, 1 year later or if a subsequent pregnancy comes earlier. So, ye hai vaccination jo mukhtalif karte hain. So, I am going to stop over here. Is there any ambiguity in the vaccination schedules? We'll कुछ नहीं हो सकता वो पहले था एक कंसर्न कि जी फर्स्ट ट्रेमेस्टर में नहीं देना, नाउ इट इज़ नोन दैट कैन बी गिवन इन फर्स्ट ट्रेमेस्टर, इट इज़ सेफ वैक्सीन. सो वेन एवर द मदर रिपोर्ट्स इन इन द प्रेगनेंसी मे बी द फर्स्ट ट्रेमेस्टर द वैक्सीन इज गिवन, बिकॉज इफ यू डोंट गिव द वैक्सीन यू मे लूज दैट मदर, शी मे नॉट कम बैक टू यू वंस अगेन. हम आ रहे हैं, हम उस पर आ रहे हैं.
Regarding the question that was answered partly by Dr. Chima, the purpose of vaccine has been seen in many studies that as the age goes on, the side effects increase and the protection decreases.
No, actually, sorry, आपकी बात काट रहा हूँ. जब भी कोई दवाई देते हैं तो इट इज़ रिस्क एंड बेनिफिट रेशियो दैट इज सीन. सो इट इज थॉट, इट वॉज थॉट एंड स्टिल थॉट इन द वेस्टर्न वर्ल्ड दैट पर्टिसेज वेयर इट इज ट्रू इज नॉट सीन इन द लेटर चाइल्डहुड. द साइड इफेक्ट्स रिमेन द सेम, सो द बैलेंस टिल्ट्स टूवर्ड साइड इफेक्ट अकॉर्डिंग टू दैट. But what we have seen in Indian studies, because there very large scale studies were done, what they have seen over there is that pertussis is very much prevalent even in the later part of first decade. So there the benefit of vaccine is more. And another reason is that that vaccine, that is DT vaccine, is not available. The manufacturers have stopped making the, that vaccine. There's no more available. So you have to give DPT.
Sir, if a mother was vaccinated during her childhood, is it necessary to repeat all these doses?
Yes. Yes.
Because I think lesser doses will not be sufficient.
It is up till now. The recommendation is that you have to vaccinate the mother, because if you vaccinate, you give a little more doses, that is not harmful. But if you do not produce enough immunity, that may be more harmful for the offspring.
I read somewhere that if a child has a mother not vaccinated before, there should be at least 1 year apart.
The EPI program does not address this. Unka hai contention ke all mothers, all women of childbearing age should be vaccinated as a policy, even if they are vaccinated as children. This is the policy. Booster dose of hepatitis B is no longer recommended. It is now known that 3 doses are sufficient to produce lifelong immunity. Booster doses are only recommended if 0, 1, 2 is given, which unfortunately our EPI program is doing, and they are not recommending a booster dose. So since that is an official program, told you that program, normally booster dose in 0, 1, 6 is not recommended. Okay, something practical. How these vaccines are given? How are they administered?
Okay,
question.
If they because in the hospital or in government centers, they say that after 9 months the course is complete. Shouldn't we tell those
exactly
to get vaccinated booster doses elsewhere instead of saying because
I think this is the discussion is beyond the scope of this. That is a political issue rather than what
they told that it is not.
That is something which is a policy of the government. Because of political reasons they can't say that, because if they start saying that, then the people would come and say why shouldn't our children get free vaccines at
वो
बिल्कुल ठीक है. आई टोटली एग्री, बट दैट इज बियॉन्ड द स्कोप ऑफ दिस.
Let us keep the scientific basis. Let us keep the scientific basis. Why those are important and necessary?
These are important because if you do not give boosters, the immunity would wean off. So if you give boosters, and for each vaccine there is a separate schedule of booster. For example, you don't need a booster in chickenpox. One vaccine is lifelong protective, but you need booster in DPT. If you don't give booster at 1.5 years, then at that point the immunity starts weaning off. So you have to boost the immunity. That is the logic behind boosters.
I think before vaccine administration, there should be some talk about storage.
And sorry, intezar karne thoda sa. So how are these vaccines administered? Kya routes kya hain? Intradermal, oral, subcutaneous, intramuscular. Intradermal कौन सी वैक्सीन देते हैं? BCG. कोई और वैक्सीन देते हैं इंट्राडर्मल? नहीं, हम बात रूटीन इम्यूनाइजेशन कर रहे हैं, नथिंग एल्स. सिर्फ BCG दी जाती है इंट्राडर्मल. उसके बाद आ जाते हैं, उसके बाद आते हैं ओरल पे. ओरल कौन कौन सी है? पोलियो एंड अ टाइप ऑफ टाइफाइड वैक्सीन. इंट्रा मस्कुलर विच वैक्सीन? विच मोस्ट ऑफ दीज के? DPT, टेटनस, हेपेटाइटिस बी, हेपेटाइटिस ए, HIV, टाइफाइड. ठीक है. और सबक्यूटेनियस? रिमेंबर, ऑल वायरल वैक्सीन्स आर जनरली, लाइव एटेन्यूएटेड वायरल वैक्सीन्स आर जनरली गिवन बाय सबक्यूटेनियस रूट. सो ये इंट्राडर्मल जो है, ये हो गई वैक्सीन जो के देते हैं. आप लोगों ने मुझे बता दिया. एंड द रूट इज इम्पॉर्टेंट बिकॉज दिस इज इम्पॉर्टेंट फॉर ऑप्टिमल एंटीबॉडी रिस्पॉन्स. You give the shot of hepatitis B in subcutaneous region, it would not produce adequate immunity. It has to be given intramuscularly in certain parts of the body and to reduce local adverse reactions. This is how an intradermal injection is given. This is BCG vaccine. The skin is stretched. अच्छा, ये कौन से बाजू पे देते हैं?
राइट.
रिमेंबर दैट इन आर प्रोग्राम इट इज गिवन ऑन द राइट डेल्टॉइड. इन प्रीवियस प्रोग्राम एंड इन मोस्ट ऑफ द अदर प्रोग्राम्स इन द वर्ल्ड इट इज गिवन ओवर लेफ्ट डेल्टॉइड. और उसका आसान तरीका ये है कि बच्चे को यहाँ से बाजू पकड़ लें. जब बाजू आप पकड़ेंगे ना, तो यू वुड स्ट्रेच द स्किन ओवर डेल्टॉइड बिटवीन योर थंब एंड फिंगर्स. And the bevel of the syringe needle is facing upwards. It is inserted in the skin at an angle of 15 degrees, very narrow angle. And it is proceeded forwards. You could see the needle passing through the skin. And when you give that dose of vaccine, there is small whitish area or veal that appears, that shows that vaccine is has gone intradermally. So, narrow gauge, actually जो हमारे पास available, हम normally specific BCG needles नहीं होती, हम insulin से ही देते हैं जो कि what I presume is 27 gauge. If we maintain the angle, it does not go subcutaneously, and we know that when there is production of veal. It would tear the skin instead of passing through. So, see, जो intradermal है वो है. जो sites हैं यहाँ पे जरा सही नजर नहीं आ रहा. एक ये site है baby में, और एक ये site है subcutaneous की. ये वाली जगह जहाँ पे आपने सबक्यूटेनियस देने. और सबक्यूटेनियस के ये गेजेस हैं, दिस इज द एंगल दैट इज मेंटेन, सो 45 डिग्रीज के एंगल से आप जाएंगे और उसको जाने से पहले आप स्किन को यूं पिंच कर लें, यहां से बाजू पकड़ा पिंच कर लें, थाई पे है तो थाई को पिंच कर लें आप, ताकि वो फैटी टिश्यूज का प्रोमिनेंट हो जाए. दैट इज हाउ इट इज गिवन इन अ चाइल्ड. ठीक है, ये 45 के एंगल पे दे रहे
हैं
जी, फैट में देनी है ना, सबक्यूटेनियस टिश्यू में. ओके, इंट्रामस्कुलर साइड, इंट्रामस्कुलर इंजेक्शन आर फॉर वैक्सीनेशन पर्पस, जो सबसे ज्यादा प्रॉब्लम होती है वो इसमें होती है. एंड द साइट डिपेंड्स ऑन द चाइल्ड्स एज एंड मस्कुलर डेवलपमेंट, एंड द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट साइट इज वास्टस लेटरलिस एंड नॉट द ग्लूटियल रीजन इन चिल्ड्रन. And deltoid muscle may be used in older children, but in younger children it is not preferable. And you should use anatomical landmarks to locate the site. Ye hai vastus lateralis. And if you divide this in upper third, middle third and lower third, junction of middle and lower third. Or deltoid mein ye wala region hai jahan pe aap denge. Never administer vaccine in the buttock. Large doses of immunoglobulins may be given. No need to go through this. Okay, this is the way the syringe is inserted vertically at 90 degrees angle, and it should enter the muscular layer, the muscle tissue. This is how vaccine is given in vastus lateralis muscle, and this is how intramuscular injection is given over the deltoid muscle. These are the this is a summary of how you put in the needle in intramuscular, subcutaneous, intravenous is not required over there, and intradermal. Okay, now the question, if the vaccine is not given at the recommended age, theek hai, common issue, bachche ko nahi karai vaccine, phir kya, what would you do?
They can be given.
Okay.
Afterwards,
so how? So whenever the child comes to you, vaccination should be started, no matter what the age is. Number 8, which vaccines should be given would actually depend on the disease pattern and natural history of disease. And remember, at one site more than one vaccines can be given. They, except for very few vaccines, do not have interactions if they are not given at the same site. So one can give many vaccines together. This is a general principle. You'll get this in your handouts. You'll get the handouts. Aap likhne ki zarurat nahi hai, handout mil jayega. Pani mein jo if you keep this in mind, you can devise a vaccination schedule at any age. BCG, OPV and DPT is given till 5 years of age. DT is recommended after 5 years, but as I said, that in Indian protocols they still give DPT, and we are also doing that because we don't have DT vaccine with us. And prior Mantoux test should be done for BCG if the child is older than 6 months of age, because if the child is already sensitized, there may be a severe local reaction. ठीक है, इससे ज़्यादा कोई problem नहीं है, but that should not stop you from vaccinating. If you can't do Mantoux test before giving BCG, give BCG. The only thing that you would do the mother to bring the child after 3 days to see if there is an accelerated response or not. So Montu's non-availability of Montu should not stop you from giving BCG. Then measles vaccine after after 9 months of age should be given, up to 12 months, and after that MMR vaccine should be given. There is some concern of vaccinating measles and BCG together. There are some authorities that say that doesn't matter if you give both together. There are some authorities that feel that there is a risk of disseminating BCG infection if you give measles vaccine simultaneously. So if there is a concern, 1 month interval should be between these two vaccines. Hepatitis B should be given for 3 doses at any age, and the 3 doses are, ye kya doses schedule hai normally, 0, 1 and 6. Hep, if one is giving hep less than 1 year, 3 doses, 1 to 2 years, 2 doses, and more than 2 years, 1 dose is given. Typhoid, chickenpox, hepatitis A vaccines, which are all optional, are given if they are required by the patient or if it is your policy to give these vaccines. Important instructions are that minimum interval between 2 doses of DPT polio, tetanus and hep should be 4 weeks. 4 weeks se pehle aap agli neend laga sakte hain. Subsequent dose should not be denied if defaulter shows within 1 year. Ek vaccine primary ki laga li hai, dusri primary ke vaccine lagni hai, the child has not come back to you at the required time, but reports back within 1 year, so you can give the subsequent dose. No need to restart the program. But if it is more than 1 year, then you need to restart the program. And measles, important thing is, even if the history of measles is there, please vaccinate the child. Why?
Because it may not be measles.
Any rash in our society is measles, and any rash that is not there is also measles. कि जी अंदर खसरा निकला है, ठीक है, जिस तरह वो ठंडा बुखार भी होता है ना हमारे यहाँ. So इसलिए measles की वैक्सीन आपने दे देनी है, even if the mother gives a history of. Okay, you have given a dose of vaccine, and then there is delay in the subsequent dose. अब क्या होगा, अगली दफ़ा आएगा झाड़ देंगे, चले जाएँ, नहीं लगाएंगे वैक्सीन, क्या करेंगे आप?
कंटिन्यू.
कब तक कंटिन्यू करेंगे? नहीं, व्हाट अबाउट द सबसिक्वेंट डोज? वही अभी मैंने इसका कुछ जिक्र भी हुआ है पहले, एक साल तक. और अगर सेकेंड और थर्ड प्राइमरी डोज जो है वो मिस है, so give those primary doses at 4 weeks interval, and then give first booster after 1 year and second booster after 3 to 4 years. Hepatitis B ke liye, remember that if the interval between the first and second dose is more than 6 months, revaccinate. And if the interval between the second and third dose is more than 1 year, revaccinate, because there you cannot take risk. ठीक है, the normal schedule is 0, 1, 6 or 0, 1, 2 or whatever. If the gap is more than 6 months between first two doses, revaccinate. If the gap is 1 year between second and third dose, revaccinate. This is a very common thing that happens in our society. Children go to the vaccination center. So बच्चे को बुखार है, वैक्सीनेशन नहीं करनी. बच्चे को डायरिया है, वैक्सीनेशन नहीं करनी. Should this be the rule, or is it all right, or is there any problem with this? Very good. It can be given. So, all minor illnesses, cough, cold, flu, minor diarrheas, minor vomitings, all diarrheas that can be treated on OPD basis are minor diarrheas. There is no need to give an interval in vaccination. It's coming to that. If there is a severe disease, and by severe disease we mean severe loose motions which require admission, pneumonia that requires admission, and illnesses that require extensive investigations, postpone till full recovery and or discharge from hospital, and make sure that the child gets vaccine after recovery or discharge. That is part of our duty. But even if you have given vaccine during vomiting and diarrhea, that should not be counted. That should be repeated after that. Okay? So, but it should not be withheld. सीवियर डायरिया में तो आपने देनी नहीं है ना. सीवियर डायरिया के अंदर आपने क्या करना है कि आपने जिस वक्त एडमिट कर लिया उसके बाद आप जब जाने लगा बच्चा फिर देंगे. हो जाए हाई ग्रेड, आपने तो उस मोमेंट की बात देखनी है ना. उसका फायदा क्या होगा? How would that help you? You know, वैक्सीनेशन में उसका कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं है, वो इम्यूनिटी वैसे प्रोड्यूस कर सकता है. सिर्फ पोलियो की प्रॉब्लम होती है कि उसमें एक कंसर्न होता है कि वो पोलियो वैक्सीन ज़ाया हो गई है. सो उसको फ़ायदा क्या? मे बी द चाइल्ड डज नॉट कम टू यू अगेन, मे बी ही गोज टू होम्योपैथ आफ्टर टू डेज. वो कहे जी डॉक्टर साहब का मैंने इलाज करा लिया, वो बड़े होम्योपैथिक डॉक्टर बड़े सियाने हैं, या वो हकीम साहब जो बैठते हैं वो सियाने हैं, उनके पास मैंने जाना है. सो यू यू हैव लॉस्ट द चाइल्ड. सो व्हाट, दैट इज नॉट अ मेडिकल इशू, दैट इज अ सोशल काइंड ऑफ इशू. ओके जी. हेपेटाइटिस बी की आप बात कर रहे हैं? ओके, हेपेटाइटिस बी वैक्सीन का के लिए व्हाट आई एम गोइंग टू टेल यू इज पीडियाट्रिक वैक्सीनेशन. देयर इज नो नीड ऑफ डूइंग एनी टेस्ट बिफोर गिविंग द वैक्सीन इन अ हाईली एंडेमिक एरिया लाइक पाकिस्तान. इवन इफ द चाइल्ड हैज हेपेटाइटिस, क्रॉनिक हेपेटाइटिस बी, इज नॉट गोइंग टू हार्म हिम. You would raise the total cost of vaccination much more by doing tests. You can't do that on all children, so it is not recommended. Adults, I don't know. It's not cost effective. What are the adverse reactions? It is very difficult to go through adverse reaction of all vaccines. Generally speaking, most of the vaccines are safe. Generally, they have very little chances of adverse effects. But can anybody enumerate a few side effects that are very common?
Local
reactions.
Fever.
Okay. Swelling, redness. और डी पी टी के बाद एक खास चीज़ होती है, समथिंग दैट हैपन्स आफ्टर डी पी टी, फीवर एंड समथिंग एल्स. सीजर्स हो सकते हैं, लेस कॉमन, लेकिन कॉमन ज़्यादा क्या है जी डॉक्टर? इरिटेबिलिटी, क्राइंग, एक्सेसिव क्राइंग. सो दिस इज़ वेरी कॉमन आफ्टर, दिस इज़ वेरी कॉमन आफ्टर आफ्टर डी पी टी. सो लेट अस सी व्हाट आर द साइड इफेक्ट्स दैट वी हैव. Local reactions, redness, swelling in nodule, especially after DBT. There can be risk of infection because of poor technique, systemic reactions of fever, malaise, and excessive crying is because of the pertussis component. And if this is significant, then it is recommended that the next time you give not the whole cell vaccine, you give the that vaccine comes by name of Infanrix, that contains DPT and acellular pertussis vaccine and tetanus. Neurological complications are fortunately rare, but one needs to know these complications, and these are seizures, encephalopathy, encephalitis can occur, and paralytic polio in oral polio vaccine. Sometimes GB syndrome can occur. Rash can occur in those vaccines that are of those infections that normally produce rash, for example chickenpox and measles.
Sir, what is the incidence of this paralytic polio?
1 in 1 million. 1 million doses. One thing that is that we need to remember, and we need to tell the parents, the mother, all the times when we are vaccinating BCG. A BCG vaccine normally gives a reaction. After 2 weeks, there is swelling, redness, a nodule 2 weeks later, which then ulcerates, discharging pus, and scar is formed. There's no need to apply any medicine on this scar, on this discharging ulcer. This should normally occur, and you should tell the parents to alleviate their anxiety, and they should be prepared for that. If the child is already is sensitized to Mycobacterium tuberculosis, then this response is quite fast, and it occurs over 2 weeks period complete, starting from 72 hours, and this is called accelerated BCG response. No need to treat that. If there is local lymphadenopathy with BCG vaccine, first thing is that you give antibiotics for 7 days, because most of the times it is because of infection that you have introduced. If the lymph nodes are not resolving, they are mated, and they appear to be tuberculous, then one might give treatment for this infection. Yes, two drugs. So what are contraindications to vaccine? Kab vaccine contraindicated hai? One is immunocompromised persons. Sari vaccines? Live vaccines are not given because they can produce infections. Or
previous
severe reaction. A child had seizures with a vaccine, you're not going to give that vaccine again. And if there is egg allergy, then you don't give measles and MMR vaccine because they are developed in the egg. ये जनाब खास तौर पे उस साहब साहब के लिए कोल्ड चेन. व्हाट इज कोल्ड चेन? It is not the minimum, it is maintenance of an optimal temperature from the production of vaccine to its administration to the patient. So at all steps, and of course we are not responsible for the steps earlier, we are only responsible for our storage. So how do we store vaccine? स्वाय डीपीटी के और नहीं है, मैं उस पर आ रहा हूँ, आई एम कमिंग टू दैट. वो जो चीज़ है ना उस पर स्वाय डीपीटी के नहीं है. डीपीटी का तरीका ये होता है कि अगर इफ़ यू लुक एट द वैक्सीन, इट इज़ वाइट सॉल्यूशन, And if the vaccine is kept for some time, the particles precipitate down. You gently shake and it becomes an even white solution. But if the vaccine is damaged, then when you shake that, there are thick precipitates and not a clear white solution. That is how you know that that BCG is not. That it, if it, we are coming to that. So how do we keep these vaccines? कैसे फ्रिज में रखेंगे? पकड़ी जहाँ पे फ्रिज में दिल किया रख दी. Near the freezer. Why not in the freezer? जम जाएगी. Okay. उससे क्या होगा? ये मैं बाद में उस पर आता हूँ. ये है जनाब, फ्रिज के अंदर ये फ्रीज़र है, ये डोर है. एक बिल्कुल कंपार्टमेंट होता है जो कि फ्रीज़र के नीचे होता है, उसको चिलर कंपार्टमेंट बोलते हैं. उसके बाद रैक्स होती हैं. किसी फ्रिज में दो होंगी, किसी में एक होंगी. फर्स्ट सेकंड रैक है, किसी में आपके पास छोटा फ्रिज है उसमें एक ही रैक होगी. और उसके बाद एक लोअर रैक है. लोअर रैक होती है जिसके अंदर आप वो रखते हैं वेजिटेबल्स वगैरह नॉर्मली. नो वैक्सीन शुड बी केप्ट इन द लोअर रैक और इन द डोर बिकॉज द टेम्परेचर्स आर नॉट एडिक्वेट. इन द चिलर कंपार्टमेंट दोज वैक्सीन्स दैट which can be frozen are kept. For example, BCG can be frozen, OPV can be frozen, measles, MMR, chickenpox, these vaccines can be frozen. If they are frozen, nothing happens to them. In fact, when they are produced and transported, they are transported in frozen form. So these vaccines are those that should be given. And those vaccines which are never to be frozen, those are DPT, DT, tetanus, TD, Hib, hepatitis B and hepatitis A. They should be kept over here.
That means that the they can be stored in freezer.
They can be. They can be. You freeze bhi kar sakte hain. Lekin ye niche wali hain, inko nahi kar sakte aap. नहीं, इनको इन्होंने पूछा कैन दोज बी फ्रोजन. द आंसर इज यस, दे कैन बी. सो यहाँ हमने कहाँ पे रखनी है? चिलर कंपार्टमेंट. चिलर में फ्रीज नहीं होगी. ओके. मैं उसी पे आ रहा हूँ. How do we know that the vaccine that is kept in our fridge is all right? You know, you've gone on vacations on the weekend and there was load shedding for a certain period of time. So how do you know the vaccine is all right? There are certain devices which are called cold chain monitors. Previously unko वैक्सीन चेन मॉडल VCMs कहा जाता है, आजकल CCMs कहा जाते हैं. एंड सम ऑफ देम आर अवेलेबल विद द वैक्सीन्स. लाइक सम पोलियो वैक्सीन्स यू कैन सी देयर इज अ स्ट्रिप ऑन दैट व्हिच हैज अ राउंड सर्कल एंड अ स्क्वायर इन बिटवीन. इफ दैट स्क्वायर डज नॉट अपीयर, दैट मीन्स दैट वैक्सीन इज डैमेज. ठीक है. सो वो आपको पता. इसके अलावा डायल मॉनिटर्स भी होते हैं इन विच इफ द टेम्परेचर राइजेज देन यू वुड नो द मैक्सिमम रीडिंग इफ यू कैन कम एंड सी लेटर ऑन. एंड अनफॉर्चुनेटली इफ देर इज सम डाउट यू हैव टू वेस्ट दैट वैक्सीन. रिमेंबर प्लीज डोंट यूज. अच्छा, वन मोर थिंग. द डोर इन दैट कीप वाटर बॉटल्स to maintain temperature, because water, as you know, has a specific heat much more than many substances. It would keep the interior of the refrigerator cool for a longer period of time if there is a power breakdown. So water is kept over there. These are certain instructions Door opening is kept to minimum, and therefore do not keep anything else besides vaccines in the vaccine refrigerator. Temperature is checked and recorded daily. Defrosting is done regularly so that the ice inside the fridge is does not build up. Do not store food or drink. Fill the lower drawers with the plastic bottles and use cold chain monitors. One more thing. In the lower racks, dilutants are given. Remember, the dilutant should also be kept in fridge. ये नहीं है कि dilutant वो आपने pharmacy से पकड़ा गरम गरम उसमें vaccine dilute कर ली, because then you waste the vaccine. Dilutant should also be kept in the refrigerator. नहीं, इतना थोड़ी सी quantity होती है, उसमें क्या फर्क पड़ेगा? 0.5 ml. The normal dose of, except for DPT, BCG, the dose of all vaccines is 0.5 ml.
The most of the dilutants, they are in the same box. So there are less chances that they can be stored elsewhere.
Pardon?
Most of the dilutants, they are in the same box.
नहीं, अगर dilutants अगर separate हैं आपके पास, separate ही मिलते हैं dilutants. This is, you'll get that. Okay. Review of the talk up till now. Vaccines are very important because they prevent disease. Vaccines should be given to all children. There is a program that we should follow. The program that is given to us by the government is up to 1 year or 9 months of age. But it is prudent to give more vaccines if it is economically feasible. Of course, you won't force some vaccine to somebody who just can't afford to get that vaccine. Vaccines are given even if they are missed. And then there is a certain schedule that you should keep in mind to give those vaccines. If subsequent doses are missed, there is no need to repeat all the vaccination. There is a certain protocol that you follow. Most of the vaccines are very safe. There are few side effects of those vaccines. And very, very important is that we should always try to maintain a cold chain at our part. We don't know what has happened before, but at least when the vaccine is with us, we should try to maintain the cold chain. So if there are any queries, for 5 minutes we can go through those. Screening, the word screening, मैंने पहले लिख दिया, लेकिन ये मैंने उस वक्त भी discuss किया था कि this is not the right thing. वो क्यों कि it is surveillance, it is not screening. What? How do we monitor the health of children? There are advanced countries, developed countries, where there is a program for developing, for monitoring the health of children at regular intervals. Unfortunately, in our country, we don't have a program for that. Who is looking after the health of these children? The most important people, I think, are you people, the family physicians, who are looking after most of the children of this country, followed by practicing pediatricians and hospitals. Vaccination is mostly given by the vaccination centers and to a little extent by doctors, both in private and government sector. And there is one service which is school health service, which is on papers existing, but in practice there is no monitoring of health of children whatsoever in our schools. The doctors who are employed by school health service work